breakfast vlog for Thursday the 18th. Check the calendar, make sure I don't get the date wrong, of 2018. Yeah, breakfast vlog Thursday the 18th, 2018. It almost rhymes. You know, every once in a while I got the Java Juice going here. It's about standard fare. We get the blanket of fog, doing the potatoes, you know, forcing my potatoes into the frying pan they hate so much. I'll make a meme out of it. The Java Juice this morning, I don't know, I hit the proportions just right. Kitty Nemesis. A couple Nemesis cats in the neighborhood that torment my cat, so. But sometimes you hit I like putting vanilla in my coffee, and, I don't measure anything in the water. You know, I make it in the machine, and it's pretty idiot-proof, but sometimes it's a little stronger, sometimes a little weaker, but today it's just perfect. So, enjoying my Java Juice. I think I showed you guys the stuff I drink. It's vacuum-packed. It's really, really fine grains. I'm sure I've showed you before, but...
Ow.
Smashed my hand. Yeah, the thing about the weights in the gym, you smash your hands with the weights every once in a while, you're not paying attention, and clang, and oh, you know. A buddy of mine almost cut his toe off with a 45-pounder. Then this is what happened to me. I said I was moving the weight over and I skipped it off a piece of metal that was protruding and it just dug off the top of my knuckle. And he had something similar happen to him, but when he hit his hand hard enough, it released. And he had the 45-pound and it let go and it came down on his sneaker and it severed his toe to like the sinew, you know. It literally just came down, you know, if you've worked out with the Olympic weights, the metal ones, they've got that edge. So if you drop it on anything on an angle, it's gonna sever. It's gonna, you know, make that ugly cut, squash cut. But yeah, so anyway, I got off easy, I guess. What do we want to talk about today? There's so much to talk about, really. I mean, I'm just gonna hit on a couple subjects and just touch on them. Just give me a quick opinion. Tomorrow, I've got to get ready for my extraction course this weekend. I don't think there'll be a video tomorrow, so just to let you know. So I want to let you know, that way you're just not waiting. Not that there's many, but there are people who watch these videos, so I want to let you know. So for those people who watch these videos, I'd like to let you know what's going on. But yeah, off to Kelowna for auto extraction, so I got to go in. I got to get my gear ready and everything. So schedule be tight tomorrow, so I might not make a video, but I might. I might just do a video at the fire hall. Who knows? Okay, so a couple things were going on. Yesterday was marijuana day, of course. Yay. I see people already. I knew it was going to happen. Yucklehead, mucklehead, knucklehead. Bong hits out in the middle. You know, come on, people. It's, you know, anyway. What can you do, eh? What can you do? People like, yeah, anyway, that's why we make silly rules. Anyway, what can you do? Anyway, so, but a couple places, thanks on article, there's a place in Kamloops, really low quality, not too much pot in the store, and the prices were just horrifically expensive. So, you know, okay, run yourself out of business. But they made it so that Joe Schmo, if you want a permit, it's going to be expensive. So you're not going to be able to just sell out your window, your front yard to the kids. So it's not a Kool-Aid stand. It's not a Kool-Aid stand. But anyway, we'll put pot to bed, you know. Happy day, pot. It's here. Probably here to stay. So we'll see we'll talk again in 10 years. Okay? 10 years. 10 years from today, we'll see what's going on. No point in bitching and moaning about it now. But I was also seeing some things on this Saudi Arabia, Khashoggi? Jamal? Okay. I don't know what happened. I don't know, I'm not into their political system in Saudi Arabia. All I can say is, Salman or something bin Salman, you know, there's so many of these, like Osama bin Laden and this bin Salman, and they just, all their names are the same. You can't, it took me 10 years to learn how to say Osama bin Hayden. So, but this kind of stuff that's going on, for you and I, doesn't matter. For me, for you, or for you and me, yeah, for you and me, it doesn't matter. You know, on the big picture, this is stuff for, like, these are country deals that are going on right now because of this misstep, we'll call it, that Mr. Liberal Saudi, you know, the new high crown Cuba, whatever, you know, you call down there in backwards land. You know, where they let women drive, sort of. But if you step out of line, you're going to jail and you're getting beheaded. So, yeah, that's always good. But like I said, the Saudi thing, like, there's a lot of... For the big players, it's going to be a big player type deal. For you and I, or for you and me, can't never ever get that one straight. It doesn't matter a hill of beans. You know, these will be deals in back, you know, somebody will get lots of weapons, somebody will get this, somebody will get that, this will get happen, you know, backroom deals. You know, you blew it. You took out a made guy when you weren't supposed to, so now you're going to have to pay. You know what I mean? This is mob stuff. This is mob rules. This is how the, you know, you screwed up. Buddy knows it too. He knows he screwed up.
Oh, wait a minute. Cat wants to go outside the window. You want to go out the window? You want to go here? I'll leave your window open if you want to go out, have your snack, and then you go outside at your own leisure.
Cat window. Forgot the cat window. Oh, I'm going to burn for that one. So these are made people. Something happened. This guy probably shouldn't have been touched, and he was. Yes, he was only a journalist, but there again, from what I gather, he was a staunch supporter of the kingdom. He wasn't on this guy's team, but he was a staunch supporter of the kingdom. It's like, you know, I love America, but I don't like Trump kind of stuff. So, but he was outspoken, so obviously they made a video about him, because I don't think he's still with us anymore. But this is like big play stuff, not little play stuff. Like, so, and it'll sort itself out in the watch. You're gonna see things happen, unfold politically, and you're gonna say, okay. And then you're gonna kind of make some loose correlation, and then when you can possibly say, okay, it's enough to just say, I'll buy that for a dollar, because then something out of the ordinary comes down the line. And they'll say, oh, well, it's probably most likely because of this. You know, the three P's, right? Probable, plausible, probable. And if it does the three P's, then, you know, you can go with it. And then you trust your gut and everything like that. But the Saudi thing, people are saying that it was an interrogation gone bad and then died, da-da-da-da-da. I think, you know, if this fella, whatever bin Salman, is as crazy and as... like Saddam's younger son or older son or whatever, the crazy one who liked to eat children. You gonna go up? Why not? Then it'll come out, you know, then probably he just, you know, did this guy in and then, you know, gonna make a video about it, show it around the, you know, the powers that be, and then say, this is what happens to those who step outside the line. You know, an example video? You know? Like, kind of like what I'll segue into my next part, and we'll just leave that one. And I'll talk a bit about Florida example videos. As I did a video a couple days ago about that fella, you know, and they're coming together and helping each other. And then, of course, today I turn on the stuff, and I'm like, oh, great, the looters are out. And, you know, I'm of a mind that I'm not too far off from the commenters. Make an example out of the looters. Put their head on a pig post, and, you know, that's it. You know, and the thing I have with looting, though, and I'll say this, and probably garner some hate for this, but when I look at big box stores that have been decimated and insured, and, you know, all of the contents is insured, most likely, and, you know, it's been ravaged by hurricane, and just, and then people are in there crawling through junk like that to loot in a, let's say, let's call it a Walmart that's been brought down. I'm of a mind like, who cares? If there's marauding gangs of looters going through neighborhoods stealing from Joe Schmo and Jane Schmain, that's a no. Pig post, head on a pig post. But the opportunistic, you know, guy going in to grab a television set or what, stupid, guilty as charged. You know, dumb, but is that the kind of looting that you really give a rat's ass about? You know, you need your neighborhood, get your neighbors together and everything like that, protect your neighborhood, but at the decimated Walmart, now if there's a fully functioning Walmart that's the only one left and everybody has to go there and it's the only and they're trying to loot that one, yeah, okay, that has to be protected. But something that's been completely decimated, you know, like a, I don't know, pick something, anything, you know, a Walmart. It always just pops in my head. I was just Zellers or Wilco, but those are Canadian and I'm dating myself and they're no more anyway. So, you know, I'm kind of torn. It's sad to see that it's happening, but there again, I think it's all, you know, the cops can't do really much anything because there's just so many people, there's so much to do, there's so much strife going on there. In my opinion, it should be just, should be boots on the ground down there. Boots on the ground, making sure that, for security, just making sure people aren't doing that kind of stuff, that's all, and let everybody go about their business, but you've got to have it where everybody's able to go about their business, but... You know, if they're, you know, if you go to a strip mall and the whole thing's on the ground and people are picking through, grabbing Bic razors and stuff like that, I don't really care. But if they're going around in like dump trucks to neighborhoods, rich neighborhoods or even poor neighborhoods, doesn't matter because that's what they're doing, then that's not on. But, you know, I'll probably get some hate for that, but that's okay. You know, that's just my opinion. It's just the way I see things. You know, I'm going to want to protect my neighbor, our area, and then everybody band together and do their own neighborhood, and then let the people, you know, like the ones who own the strip mall, worry about the strip mall. Because the strip mall is screwed. It's down. It's a pile of rubble. You know, protect the ones that are still standing. But that's about it. That's about as long as all I can say about that. So, you know, good luck with that, you know, because I can tell you right now, you know, the resources are probably stretched right to the thin in Florida right now in the Panhandle where that hurricane came ashore. Devastating, absolutely, totally, yeah, and they need help down there big time, you know, they need it all. I don't think they've got anything, I mean, it's just totally wiped out, but it won't surprise me if I see some problems coming up from the looting, and of course, if anything, the mainstream media will be down there like a dirty shirt. If it goes to the point where they can manipulate it into a political thing. I'm not going to argue that, but it's just the reality of the situation. So, you know, I'd like to see people coming together a little bit stronger. I'm sure the neighborhoods have, and I'm quite happy about that. Around the bigger box areas where there's strip malls and places where there's all kinds of stuff, and people who are impoverished, and you know that Florida is very, very, I was down there in school for 6 months, and I'm literally, you're driving in Niceville, and you cross the tracks, and you're on the scene of cops. It's that quick. Just like that. BMW, Junker Pinto. Okay? You can't have that kind of separation and not have problems, so, you know. I mean, it doesn't surprise me one bit, but hopefully things will sort themselves out, so hopefully the sun comes out. Yesterday was a little behind the eight ball, but you know, like around 12 o'clock when the fog lifts, but yesterday was around 1 o'clock, and it was colder, so as the days it gets colder, it's just going to slow to the point where this stuff can't burn off. You might get a bluish tinge through it, but that'll be the end of it, so it'll be interesting to see. Anyway, I'm rambling. Peace to you and yours. Hope to see you on the flip side. If there's no video tomorrow, I'll see you on Monday. Peace to you and yours.